or something like that. We're going to learn something like that today. Hello, my name is Zack, and welcome to Zack Wing Music. Welcome to my channel. This is the, I think, 10th, I'm not sure, episode of Jazz for the Rest of Us, where we're taking jazz music theory concepts and we're cramming them into non-jazzy styles of music. In the past two videos, we've learned how to use the Dorian mode, the Lydian mode, and the Mixolydian mode. And I told you guys that when a chord kind of pops up out of nowhere, you can think about it as being the 2 or the 4 or the 5 of something else, of another key. When it doesn't make sense in the key that it's in, you can think about it as being in another key, and then you can solo on top of it. So in all three of those, while you were still doing something outside of the main key that you were working with, you were still thinking about it in another key. You were still, it was derivative of another key. Today, we're going to start something new. We learned how to solo over major seventh chords, minor seventh chords, and dominant seventh chords that just kind of come out of nowhere. They don't really seem to make a lot of sense. Today, we're going to learn a way to solo over half diminished chords, and it's going to be a little different. So let's say that we are in the key of C and we have this kind of like funky major thing going on. So the first chord is C, do 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 do, and then we go to a D half diminished, and then we go to a G. That's not important. That's not today's lesson. Don't worry about that. Just worry about the D, and then we get back to the one. So we have C major 7, D half diminished, G. It's a sharp 5 for those of you who are wondering, and then back to the C. I'm essentially doing the 2-5-1 of C minor, but on the 1, I'm doing a major, just because I want to, because I think that sounds kind of cool. So, of course, on that C major 7, of course, we're going to play C major notes, we're going to play from the C major scale, and everything's going to sound happy and perfect and wonderful. But then we slide up to that D half diminished. What do we do there? Well, if we were going to use the logic that I told you in the last videos, you would say, okay, it's a diminished chord, it's a half diminished chord. We're going to think about it as the something of something else. We're going to think about it as the 1 or the 2 or the 3 or the 4 or the 5 or the 6 or the 7 or the 7 of some other key. What would that be? Well, it's a diminished chord, and we know that when we're taking chords out of a major scale, the only time we get a diminished chord is on the 7, and it is a half diminished chord if you take the 7th. So you could say, okay, this is D half diminished, which is the 7 of E flat major. When you're extracting chords from the E flat major scale, the 7th one, the chord that starts on the 7th degree, is a D half diminished. So it's perfect, right? So we should play notes from the E flat major scale. We should play the E flat major scale on top of this, and it should sound splendid, right? Wrong. That is not what we're going to do. And we actually have to use a little bit of different logic for this one. Even if we were in the key of E flat, even if this D half diminished was a naturally occurring thing, scale, using the E flat major scale would sound okay, but that E flat note doesn't really sound that good on top of the D half diminished because it's a half step above the root note. And that doesn't sound very good. Whenever you put a note a half step above the root note of a chord, it doesn't really sound very good. Pretty much all the other notes of the E-flat major scale sound good on top of a D half diminished, which makes sense because you can get a D half diminished out of the E-flat major scale. That makes perfect sense. But that E-flat doesn't really work that well. That E-flat note doesn't really seem to really fit on top of a D half diminished in a lot of context. So what do? We take that E-flat and we raise it half a step to E, and we play the E-flat major scale with the E instead of an E-flat. If we weren't going to raise the E-flat up to an E, then this would be called Locrian. We would be playing in Locrian, just like there's Dorian and Lydian and Mixolydian, you know all those. When you think about something as the 7 of something else, it's called Locrian. So if we were to just play E-flat major notes, starting on D and ending on D, that would be D Locrian. But we are taking the second note of the D Locrian mode, meaning the E-flat, and we are raising it up half a step. So you could call this Locrian sharp 2. Or sharp 2 Locrian, or Locrian raised 2, or Locrian with the half, the second note higher. It doesn't matter what you call it, it just has to sound good. So we're going to play the notes of an E-flat major scale, but we're going to raise the E-flat up to an E. So what does that give us? That gives us D, no E-flat, that's an E, and then F, and then G, and then A-flat, B-flat, C, D. And you can think about it just like that. You can just think about it as playing the E-flat major scale without the E-flat, with an E instead of an E-flat. And you can do that, and you can play your little hearts out just like that. But I'm going to teach you something else to make this a little bit easier. There is a thing called the melodic minor scale. There's a scale called the melodic minor scale. and I have not taught it yet in this series. It is the same as a major scale, but the third is lowered half a step. So if the C major scale is C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, then the C melodic minor scale would be C, D, E flat, F, G, A, B, C. Other than that, it's the same. It's the major scale, but that third is lowered. And that is called the melodic minor scale. Side note, in classical music theory textbooks, they say that when the melodic minor is going up, when it's ascending, like this, it is like I just said, with a major scale with the flat in three. And for some reason, when it's descending, they say that it's a natural minor scale. Or was it something else? I don't really remember. It's different on the way down in classical music circles. I don't think like that. Jazz musicians don't think like that. And a lot of people don't think like that. I actually don't know why it's different on the way up and on the way down in classical circles. So if someone knows why that is, you should write it in the comments. But when I say melodic minor scale, it's the same on the way up and the same down. If I remember correctly, this has a name in jazz circles, like the jazz melodic minor scale or something like that. I don't know. But for me, it's the same on the way up and the way down. End of side note. So we said that we were going to take an E-flat major scale, raise the E-flat up to E, and that was going to give us the notes that we were going to play on top of the D half diminished. And we said those notes were D, E, F, G, A-flat, B-flat, C, D. Those are the notes that we're going to use on top of the D half diminished. So let's just do a little experiment right here. Let's do an F major scale. What does an F major scale look like? F, G, A, B flat, C, D, E, F. Okay? You'll notice that the F major scale and the notes that we are going to use are very similar. They both have seven notes. Six of them are the same. One of them is different. Which one is different? The third degree of the F major scale is A. And in the notes that we're going to use, we're going to play an A flat instead of an A. And all the rest of them are the same. So if we were to take that third degree of the F major scale and lower it and keep the rest of them the same, then those two scales would be the same. What that means is if we were to play the F melodic minor scale, we would get the same notes as those other notes that we said we were going to play on top of D half diminished. What did we call that? Locrian sharp 2 or whatever that is? So rather than thinking about Locrian sharp 2, or rather than thinking about E-flat major scale without the E-flat with the E instead, you can think about it as F melodic minor. If this is a new concept for you, you're going to have to learn to play the melodic minor scale. If you're a guitarist, you're going to have to get it under your fingers and... It might be something new for you, but we will talk a lot more about it in the future. So go ahead and start learning how to use that, how to solo with that, either if you're a pianist or a guitarist or whatever you are. So I have recorded on my looper that chord progression that I just told you about. We have C major 7, D half diminished, and then G sharp 5. Don't worry about the sharp 5. We haven't talked about that yet. So that's going to sound like this. We got C, 2, 3, 4. C major 7, 2, 2, 3, 4. Then the D half diminished for one measure. And then we have the G sharp 5 for another measure. And then it starts over. Just like in the last video, I don't think I can play very well on a complex chord progression like this and tell you exactly what I'm doing real time at the same time. So I'm going to put the subtitles, the whatevers on the screen to tell you the logic, to tell you what I'm playing, what scales I'm using, whatever, to help you understand what I'm doing. And hopefully I can play something kind of cool. So let's see what I can do with this. 1, 2, 3. Once again, a very average solo, but you get the idea. So in the last two videos, when we had chords that we didn't know what to do with, we had minor chords, dominant chords, and major chords, major seventh chords, we thought about them as belonging to another key, a foreign key. So we were still thinking in terms of keys. Now we are looking at the chord in itself and saying, what notes sound good on this chord? We know that the notes from an F melodic minor scale sound good on top of a D half diminished. So that's what we're going to play. We're going to play an F melodic minor scale on top top of a D half diminished. If you want to make that easy, go up from the root note of the half diminished chord 1, 2, 3 half steps, and then you can use the notes from that melodic minor scale. So starting at D, you would go D, E flat, E, F. That would be up 3 half steps to the F, and then we'd use that melodic minor scale. You could also think about this as the 6th mode of the F melodic minor scale, but no one really talks about it like that. People typically call it Locrian sharp 2 or something like that. The relationship here is different because we're not thinking about the D as belonging to another key. We're thinking about it kind of independently on its own. We're not thinking about it really as the 6th of F because the F is melodic minor. You can't be in the key of melodic minor. That's not a thing. So we're just saying, what notes sound good on this chord? Those are the notes that we're going to play. And that is essentially how we're going to handle the rest of this series. So I hope that the video was helpful. I hope that it was educational and informational. And if you like the video, you should subscribe so that you don't miss another one. And you should like me on Facebook and follow me on Instagram and share me and make me famous. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments. I would prefer you to leave them in the comments rather than send me a message so that the rest of the world can see your wonderful question and my answer. Be on the lookout for my next video. I don't know what it's going to be, but it's going to be something like this: a chord scale relationship. What scale can I use on top of this chord? What notes can I play on top of this chord and make it sound good? So that's what we're going to be doing for pretty much the rest of the series. So I'm going to do some more jamming on this chord progression, and I hope to see you guys in the next video.